Sunday morning with Labor's victory in the crucial by-election in the outer suburban Melbourne seat of Dunkley. The party managing to hold on to the seat, but not without a bit of a swing towards the Liberals. Let's head live to Nine's political editor, Charles Croucher, who is in Melbourne for us. Charles, good morning. What does this mean for both leaders?
G'day, Clint. Well, look, Anthony Albanese will take this. A win's a win is the phrase coming from Labor this morning. The swing was about 3.8%. And if you're putting that across the country, which is difficult to do, that's another 11 Labor seats that would now be vulnerable if that swing was uniform. But this was a crucial seat. It's an outer suburban street. And increasingly, we're seeing this being the path to victory for both major parties. As for the Liberal Party, well, they've probably found their candidate for the next election in Nathan Conroy. He managed to halve that margin. He's now better known in the community and better placed for a run in the future, although he did announce as part of that concession speech last night that his wife is now pregnant with their second child, so a complicated time ahead. Look, the crux of it is Jodie Bellier will be the new member for Dunkley. She will succeed the late Peter Murphy. The leaders, well, they weren't in town last night. Both of them got out and left it to their deputies. Here's Richard Miles and Susan Lee.
We go to bed every night and we'll do so from here on in, thinking about how we can improve Australians' lives, how we can make the family budget better, how we can fight for working Australians.
So I've looked at some signs. There was actually an interesting one that said, vote for Nathan Conroy is a vote for Peter Dutton. Well, my oath it is.
So that's the message being taken there. Look, cost of living is the crucial issue. It was at the centre of the debate at Dunkley. It is one of those aspirational seats. And I think the Liberal Party will look to the seat, the booth in Frankston itself. We know that is one of those emerging mortgage-built towns and parts of Melbourne that reflects so much of middle Australia around the country. A 10% swing there to the Liberal Party. But it was still won by Labor. So a little of something for both parties this morning, Clint.
Sure is. Charles Croucher live in Melbourne. Thank you. Top story, Labor has, of course, retained the Victorian seat of Dunkley. That's despite a swing of about 4% to the Liberal Party. Yesterday's by-election was seen as a major acid test for both the PM and opposition leader. But neither really came away with a ringing endorsement. For more, let's bring in Nine's Heidi Murphy in Melbourne. Hides, thanks for your time on Weekend Today. Labor's victory this morning, it's been called a win for the PM. Do you agree?
Well, I mean, he's got a new MP. They won at the end of the day. So, it is a victory for the PM. Whether it's quite as convincing as he would like it to be, not necessarily. But the ultimate is, yes, Labor won this seat, held this seat, kept it with a swing, but a pretty traditional swing in a by-election against a sitting government. Yeah, he gets to claim a win. The coalition does get to take something away from it too, though. They did manage to peg that margin right back, make it far more competitive next election.
So let's talk about Peter Dutton now, because he said he wanted to go after suburban voters. And Dunkley is exactly that. It's a seat he means. It was once held by Bruce Bilson and the Liberals. What can he take away from this result?
Well, it is. This is the sort of seat. This is the middle Australia. This is the working class. This is where his attacks around cost of living should be working. This is where his attacks on the car and ute tax should be working. They should be resonating, these messages. He'll need to do a lot more to get over the line. There was an increase to the primary vote for the Liberal Party in this seat. He'll take something away from that, but there's going to need to be much sharper attack lines and probably some fresh policies that give people a reason to vote for that party. There's still a lot of work to do. If these outer suburban seats are the ones that are winnable for him, there's going to need to be a significant increase.
Worth noting, no UAP or One Nation vote, though. An election, right, of course, could be called any time from, what, August this year. What work do both major parties still need to do?
Well, Labor probably just needs to hold steady, keep on doing what it's doing, because it's working. There was the talk of this being a real test for Albanese, is the honeymoon completely over? Was he too distracted last year by the referendum? Has he done enough around cost of living? People have gone, yeah, it's going all right, we'll stick with it. The coalition's the one that's got to really lift its game to shift votes. It's got to shift a lot more votes than a few in the outer suburban seats. That's the real challenge ahead for the coalition.
And another interesting postscript to this. In recent elections, we've of course seen a voter shift away from the major parties. In Dunkley yesterday, it was the Greens that took a bit of a hit, a swing against them. What do you think we put that down to?
I think it was a real lack of effort, lack of engagement. There wasn't a huge presence on the polling booths. There wasn't that real grassroots campaign that we've become quite familiar with the Greens and with some of those other niche parties. They just didn't put the effort in. And as you say, One Nation wasn't standing. There weren't those other fringe parties running this time round. I guess they just went, well, it's a by-election. We'll let this one go, save our efforts for next year. The Advance Australia Party is going to have some thinking ahead after spending $250,000, I think it was, in this particular electorate. Did they get bang for that buck? I don't think so.
Probably not. Heidi Murphy in Melbourne, thanks so much for your insight.
Thanks, Clint.
Jane.
Labor has won a crucial victory in the Dunkley by-election in Melbourne, but not without losing some skin. Cost of living concerns contributed to a swing towards the Liberal Party of almost 4%. But that's not exactly the thumping that Peter Dutton was hoping for. Let's bring in today's talkers, Nationals leader David Littleproud and Nova's Michelle Stephenson. Good morning to you both. David, what did you think? Did you think that swing would have or should have been bigger? And what lessons will the coalition take from this?
Yeah, I think it's a swing that I expect, and I think it's a good swing. You put this in perspective, this is a Labor seat in a Labor state, and if this is replicated at the next federal election, there'll be 11 Labor members at the moment that won't have their jobs after the next federal election. There'll be 2 Green members in Queensland that won't have their seats after the next election. And 6 of the 7 Teal seats that are effectively Liberal seats will flip, I believe, because those people will believe that if they don't get rid of their Teal candidate, they'll get Anthony Albanese for another 3 years. So I think Peter Dutton can take a lot out of this. This is game on. This is really game on, and I think it shows that people are hurting out there. The government's been adrift in tackling those cost of living pressures, whether it be your mortgage, whether it be your power bill or your food bill. They'd wasted $450 million on a voice referendum that people weren't interested in, and all of a sudden it's dawned on them they need to do something about this. I think this is a real big message to Anthony Albanese. For us, it's about making sure that discipline and consistency of messaging around what is important to the Australian people, and they're hurting out there. People making real decisions at the checkout at the moment. They're putting fresh produce back on the shelf. So we have to do whatever we can, and I think not in just highlighting it, but coming forward with sensible solutions, and that's why the Nationals want to try and continue to work on divestiture powers of supermarkets and have a sensible energy policy. So I think there's some big messages there for the government, some more for us to continue on the pathway we are, but this is game on.
Well, Michelle, you're hearing from the coalition there. This is definitely the mood they're taking from this. It is, however, a pretty typical result for a by-election, it must be said. Do you think it's going to result in a change in policy in either side?
Yeah, I do think so. I do think it is sending a message to Labor and Albanese. A 3.8% swing in a very tightly held Labor state, I think, is probably the message that Albanese is getting out of this. Cost of living, as David Littleproud was talking about, is a big one here. I think they're going to have to make some changes and kind of get people back on board. But, you know, for Dutton, I don't think it was the swing that he was hoping for. So I think also the Liberal Party has to do some more work and try and get their message across and try and, like, get those voters back as well.